winners of 8 NFL championships, including 4 Super Bowls. The New York Giants are one of the league's most successful teams.
Sam's throws, end zone, a ball, touchdown!
Bill, take it away.
In the legacy of their late owner, Wellington Mara, the Giants have Hall of Fame players, as well as unlikely stars, like those who helped spark their recent Super Bowl wins.
And the Giants have won Super Bowl 46!
You bring players into your program, and what you're trying to do is to zoom in on guys who can make a difference. Not just the great players, but the soldiers. Your team is as good as the 53rd guy.
It's gonna be caught. Was he inbounds? Yes!
Mario Manningham was a third-round draft pick, while David Tyree was taken in the 6th round.
Wide open Tyree, who makes the catch!
And Victor Cruz was undrafted.
And he does the salsa in the Patriots' end zone.
Scouting to this organization since the time of Wellington Mara has been a very highly respected part of the way in which we win.
My dad recognized at a very early age himself that the only way to learn this business was to learn how to pick the players, how to get the players on your team. They were the backbone of the team.
My father was probably the first scout. He started in his late teenage years and then throughout college.
He never really played when he was younger, so he had to learn kind of on-the-job training.
He loved nothing more than going to games and preparing reports and was always in charge of our draft in the early days.
Back then, there was no science about it. It was pretty much luck, and it was doing a little bit of research. You weren't doing that research on the internet. You were digging through magazines like Street & Smith.
Equipped with stacks of football publications and a pencil, Mara built the Giants.
There's like 3 file drawers full of these old magazines from Street & Smith, and probably starting around 1949. I got them all out and started looking at them. And on a select amount of players in pencil, underlined. I know Wellington Mara underlined those names. Who else could have underlined those names? They had no scout. The astonishing part of this was these were all preseason magazines. How many of those names played in the league?
The modern era for scouting at the Giants traces back to the early 70s, when future general managers George Young and Ernie Accorsi, both then with the Colts, found an ironic source of inspiration.
When we were in Baltimore, we didn't, nor did anybody else, like the Dallas Cowboys. But I remember George saying, they have a system and it works.
Every year we process about 4,000 college players and we eliminate those 4,000 down to about 800 by the time of the draft.
Gil Brandt and Tex Schramm revolutionized scouting. They were way ahead of everybody.
The Cowboys got into the use of computers in 1962. We felt that we had to do something that would enable us to evaluate football players faster.
He would be on the road all the time, but he researched all these people. He had tremendous contacts.
Vince, you got him really going here today.
Now, that system's been modified and changed, but the foundation of that system still lives with the Giants. Now, all that said, as important as the system that George Young brought to the Giants in 1979, the main reason that the Giants have drafted well are the scouts.
The scouts are really the boiler room guys. They really make everything work. You win Super Bowls, you never see any of the scouts up on the podium holding up the trophy. But those guys go out and find the players for us.
The Giants today have 10 scouts across the country, which is divided into 5 areas: Northeast, Southeast, Midwest, Southwest, and West. Coordinating their efforts is Vice President of Player Evaluation Mark Ross, who sets the course for the season.
Based off of Bledsoe's grades and based off of their evaluations, I set up our map here. The green dots represent what we determine to be the A schools, and the red dots are the B schools. Now, this could change during the year based on how players perform, but I just like to have a visual of where my scouts are going throughout the year.
Typical day, if you're out of school at 7 o'clock or 7:30 in the morning, you're there all day. If they have an afternoon practice, you're not leaving practice till 5, 5:30. And if you have a 2-hour drive someplace, now it's 7:30. I like to check into the hotel, and the first thing I do is I order room service, and then I call home. and you're on the phone for 20, 25 minutes. You have your computer set up and start typing.
It takes a special person that can go out on the road and be disciplined to be where they're supposed to be and to be accountable, knowing that nobody is micromanaging you and looking at you. The only thing that they know is by your information that you put on your piece of paper at the end of the day.
It's our job to give them the right information or as good information as we can for them to make the proper decision.
For a complete assessment of prospective players, the Giants scouts make their schedules using the three-look approach.
We do try to look at the player early in the season, then we try to look at them in the middle of the season, then we try to look at them late. Three different scouts, especially the high-rated players, we try to look at them like that. Because players can change, you know. They can start out the year slow and finish up strong, or they can start out strong and finish up slow. So you can try to put together all early, middle, and late looks, and hopefully you can come up with the right grade on the players.
So now you'll have the three scout reports from the fall, the general manager 5, the scouting director 6, now the position coach 7. The head coach, Tom, writes reports too. So now you got 8, and that's how we come to a consensus.